So when we start bringing sentiments that drums sound something to do with tribal sentiments of narrowing the scope of issues which are being discussed that has got impact in the entire country, then that's where we go wrong.
The government chief whip, Honorable Dennis Hamson Bua, alongside NRM legislators in parliament, have come out to defend the position of the government on the rationalization of government agencies and the public expenditures bill, saying it has to be enacted. In a press conference held at Parliament today, Obua revealed that the Cabinet and the NRM caucus held four meetings in which a resolution was passed to support the rationalization of government agencies and public expenditure through the enactment of the legislation in Parliament, sector by sector.
I wish to state that the position of the National Resistance Movement, both agreed in Cabinet and in the NRM Parliamentary Caucus, up to this point as I speak, still stands to support the presentation and passing into law all rationalization bills, providing for a 3-year transitional period for UCDA and NITA-U.
Obua affirmed that there's no rush by the government to pass the bill, adding that the decision to have the agencies rationalized was agreed upon in 2021 after conducting necessary consultation with stakeholders.
From the record available, Cabinet of the Republic of Uganda approved the principles of rationalization in 2021.
During the press conference, some NRM MPs urged their counterparts to come out boldly and defend the position of the government on the rationalization of the Uganda Coffee Development Authority. They further warned against tribal sentiments being propagated by some politicians, which they say is diversionary. Uganda Wildlife Authority, UWA, has outlined a comprehensive plan to transform Entebbe Botanical Gardens into a premier tourism, conservation and research center. This follows the merger between UWA and Uganda Wildlife Education Center, UWEC. UWA's acting executive director, Makombo John, revealed that the authority aims to develop tourism products and services. He also emphasized the need to heighten the security of the visitors to the facility.
So we are basically here to tell you that we have taken over. Number two, we are actually trying to see how we can understand the place and then do a good plan hereafter, so that we can develop it better, and the facility should look even more profitable than what it is.
The merger between Uganda Wildlife Authority, UWA, and the Uganda Wildlife Conservation Education Center, UWEC, was implemented under the government's Rationalization of Government Agencies and Public Expenditure RAPEX program, which aims to enhance efficiency and reduce duplication in public service. Britain is hiking taxes by £40 billion, approximately $52 billion, to fill a black hole in public coffers, Finance Minister Rachel Reeves announced on Wednesday in the Labour government's first budget since winning power.
The scale and seriousness of the situation that we have inherited cannot be underestimated. Together, the hole in our public finances this year, which recurs every year, the compensation schemes that they did not fund, and their failure to assess the scale of the challenges facing our public services, means that this budget raises taxes by £40 billion.
Britain's first woman chancellor of the Exchequer today said the £25 billion would come from hiking employers' national insurance contributions, a payroll tax used to help pay for social care. Changes to inheritance tax will raise more than £2 billion, while the government, headed by Prime Minister Keir Starmer, is also hiking taxes on capital gains and property purchases. This is the Labour government's first budget after 14 years of conservative rule.